Okay, hi, I'm Marios from Greece. So I'm going to discuss a bit of how we organized an online training for educators last year. This is just one of the programs we do for education. In Greece we have focused the last years a lot in Wikipedia education program. We have organized different web projects since 2010 in various schools. We have tried many approaches. We have worked with elementary schools, secondary schools, universities. We have organized the various school projects. In the CE last year, I presented one of these projects. So with the numbers we have counted so far, we have more than 1,200 students in our education programs, and we have created a lot of content, about 440 articles in Greek Wikipedia, not only there. And we also started making different approaches to the subject, like we have also worked with Commons a lot in uploading photos, and we also have worked with Dictionary to also work in the sister projects, because we have noticed at some point that adding content in the Wikipedia had its limits. So we have started to reach some limits of what secondary students could really contribute, and we have to start to find different ways to contribute. Still alive? Okay. Good. So one of the ideas we had this year is, instead of going to schools and organizing school projects by ourselves, is to start massively educate educators to educate students in order to multiply the effect. And so one thing I want to say about the Greek reality is that the school program allows school projects, so people, students, professors can organize school projects in the school program. So the idea is that we have to get advantage of this in order to make this Wikipedia projects instead of something else. We worked 1 year in order to gather information of which teachers were doing already Wikipedia projects in the school. We contacted them and we started our work. We found the data from the secondary education principals in Greece, and then we distributed a video that we are interested in educating them. Okay, this is a video, probably I don't want to play it right now, just a teaser video in a way. We also created, something is wrong here, should be better. Anyway, we made the flyer, we went to hundreds of schools, and we invited teachers to come to us to be educated. And there were about, we had a pre-registration of 300 teachers that they wanted to attend, and about 200 made it to the next stage to start being educated by us in a seminar that lasted, workshops that started, lasted 8 weeks. It was 8 weeks of modules.
So long.
Yeah, we were giving assignments each week, and we were giving them tasks to do, and we had some education. I'll show you later. It was mainly people working in primary schools, and of course mainly people working in public education in Greece. But we also have very important 10% of university teachers or professors that want also to participate. And we also had 15% professors working in adult education, because this is the area I also was working, so I had many contacts in this area. I've been working in this area for many years. And this is important because adult education means adults that haven't finished the secondary education. And we have made a lot of studies that shows that this is a very appropriate area to work with, because you have adults, so they already have experiences. They still can do school assignments, and they can combine knowledge they already know about, things about they already know, And so school projects are a really good area for them to work. And you can also organize, for example, excursions to take photos with no more bureaucracy, etc., etc., instead of working with children under 18 years old. And so we had almost 300 people interested, 150 people enrolled, and we had 51 people that finished the course. This is because of that, because it was really, we aimed too high in the things we asked from the people to do every week. And probably we asked them to do a lot of stuff in Wikipedia, like assignments, editing. We mixed things like they had to edit Greek Wikipedia, English Wikipedia, upload photos in Commons, edit in Wiktionary, use automated tools. So every week we had a lot of, even in edit wiki data. So I think we aim too high for that. And one of the things we wanted to achieve with that is exactly to break the idea that Wikipedia is not a reliable source. So in the beginning, we asked how many people thought Wikipedia is a reliable source. We have 11% of people thinking it's not a reliable source, but many people also being neutral about it, whether it's reliable or not. And then we asked them to add their own citations in Wikipedia. And this convinced them that at the end that Wikipedia is reliable or can be more reliable. What we did was we established a MOOC using WordPress and add-on called LearnPress. During the preparation, LearnPress was completely reconstructed, so we had to do everything from the beginning. But it was really good because LearnPress, if you ever used it, provides a lot of things. You can create your own modules. And this was set up in our own platform, so we could have completely control of the statistics of the people participating. And we also required from everyone to fill out a questionnaire every week, and there were also some quiz questions about how much they have understood by from the Wikipedia rules. So this is like what we did in the platform. For example, this is lesson 1 and 2. It contains introductory videos. It contains some videos we translated from Wikipedia. We had subtitles. It contains things like the first week they had just to create an account, etc., etc., make the first edit. And so we were aiming to people who had never heard of how to edit Wikipedia before. They just knew about Wikipedia. And we started in eight weeks making them go deeper and deeper. So, for example, week 8 contains editing Wikidata and connecting Wikidata to a Wikipedia project. One of the things we do is, for example, we translated these videos that they were already online, Vasi and others created, and we subtitled everything in Greek. This was one of the things they had to do every week, to watch one of these videos, except I think the last one, because something about recruiting new members, so it was not really addressing to them, but mainly addressing to Wikipedia already. As you see, the vast majority of the participants, we made a questionnaire, of course, to control everything, said that it was really extremely valuable to watch these videos. And then we also created our own videos from scratch, completely in Greek, because, we also had we faced some problems with that, with language borders. Some people said that we should have done everything in Greek, and there's also one reason we created the entire platform from the beginning. So whether they spoke English or not, people wanted to have this in their own language. And so we created the introductory videos of how to edit Wikipedia from the scratch. I don't know, we created more than 10 videos with commentary. And as you see, the number also, a huge number, obviously more than 50% of the people that agree that these videos were extremely valuable. For example, there was every week there were some questions about, for example, do you know what are the 5 pillars of Wikipedia? This kind of questions. And we also provide links to policies for read more, etc. And we also start translating, because in Greek we had problems. Not everything from the manual was translated in Greek, so we had to translate all the manual in Greek in order to provide it to them. So we spent a lot of time in order to translate all the rules, even some essays that were really interesting for them to read in Greek. And we provided text for them to read, and then we also asked questions in the questionnaires and in the quizzes about for that. And what else we did is that we organized every week a Skype session live, so people could join us and make questions about what they learned during the week. And we used YouTube provides a platform called YouTube Live, which is now still in beta version, but people can join through Hangouts, watch the video, and make questions, even text, or really come online and talk. And what's important with this platform is that after you record the video, this becomes already online recorded with the questions and everything.
As a webinars.
Yes. So what we did, yeah, we provided every week a webinar in addition to this. And one part of that is that we approached professors from Greece that they already organized school projects to talk about the school projects and how they experienced to the new professors, to the educated professors. And then we also start calculating how many people were really online and how many people were viewing the videos the next weeks. And yeah, we realized that most of the people want to work in their own pace. What else we did? Everybody had their own schedules because it was very difficult. We organized that last year during the school period. So we demand from them to be in afternoons and participate in that. And that's why in the beginning we had a very strict timeline, and then we had to extend like 2 weeks to allow them to finish the assignments. Yeah, because we thought that we were treating them very bad at some point. It was too demanding, and they also wanted to have some certification that they finished, and we were very strict. No, if someone passes the deadline, there's no certification. And you see, only one of the third made it in the time frame. And we asked how much time they spend per week in this project. In fact, 80% of the people spend 1 to 3 weeks hours per week, and 50% 4 to 5 hours per week. In fact, okay, we were more confident that we would spend like 2 hours per day, so we expected a bit more. But anyway, this is of the things we want to fix in the future. We also then we made a Google form in order to ask opinions about it, and we recorded everything. They were really willing in helping us improve it in the project and the platform. There were even comments about the platform, the LearnPress, the MOOC in general, and there were also many questions about how to customize this in a very specific school project in their own profession. Like, there was a teacher of English, and they wanted very specific questions of how to organize a school project in English, or for a professor in history, or a professor in geography. And we had some examples, but what we have done till now, it was more generic things, or they were focusing in mathematics, because I'm a mathematician. So we didn't have, we couldn't provide all the answers to that. Anyway, this is one of the comments they did. What else? So all this thing was done by, in fact, four people and one designer that helped us create the design of the flyer and the teaser videos. In fact, we were like three professors and one more person helping in the support, and the entire thing lasted 10 weeks, 8 plus 2 we added in the beginning. The cost was €0. Some of the money for the printouts were covered by the schools themselves, The MOOC we did them completely voluntary, and everybody was volunteer in the situation. So this was done with no money at all.
With volunteer time.
Oh, yeah, with a lot of volunteer time.
Okay,
I have to admit that it also existed my available time at some point. It was really demanding at some point. Because it's not only what you see. We were getting emails every day, and from stupid things like the name written on the certification is it's spelled wrongly, from really questions, even from proposals for participation, or even proposals to visit a place to meet the teacher and the students, which the things I plan to do in the future. And even proposals from now I have a proposal from the entire area of Corfu to go there and organize this in person for about 20 schools, and they want to do the same time frame with online but also live meetings. This is what we are going to do next week, next semester. If you have a question already.
Oh, sorry.
I'm talking too fast, probably.
I also
listening.
Uh-huh.
The microphone has a word limit, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's very interesting to hear this, because we made the mock with Finnish teachers also. Well, they were from basic education. And the thing is that we first made it voluntary work, the first mock, but then the Ministry of Culture and Education thought that this is so important that they paid for us to make it 3 times more, the same mock.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have.
So it's many times stuff like this. You do something from your good heart, and then the other people see that this is really important work, and then they begin to support your work.
Yes, that's true. For example, now part of the Ministry of Education is really interested in that.
Okay.
They saw that. So yeah, we have two proposals. One is in my island, but the other is in Athens. I don't know how I'm going to do it, in fact, because they need some also in-person seminars, live seminars for that. Yeah, and what else I want to say? Yeah.
Christian, will you keep it for free?
The platform is for free until now. I don't know how we're going to do it in the future. I don't know. Probably we have to ask for a grant or something. I don't know how we are going to do that. But the platform is going to be free for the teachers being educated.
Because, for example, our experiences is that if it's something for free, it's not so much valuable for people, that some people just interrupt the course in the middle of it.
Yeah, that's
what about Wikipedia being provided for free?
What they found important, they want many asked for official certification that they have been educated in this thing, and some others find that as a good opportunity to create school projects that are really quality projects, and because we also have very focused in educational congresses. I'm present in every conference in Greece in education, and they find there's a good opportunity to write papers on that, or I'm being even asked by teacher students to make a master's thesis or things on that. Yeah, I probably have to also write my part. for example, I have 12 papers in presenting these school projects in 3 years. I record everything, and we have a lot of documentation right now written. But the board of being free is not that big problem. As soon as they get an official certification, and this is one of the things we want to do, but we want to do it in cooperation with the Ministry of Education to be completely legal, let's say, and in the frame. Because, of course, we will issue a paper, but I would prefer if we did it during in collaboration with the Ministry of Education. And we have good signs that this may happen. The only big problem, it's a new change that happened, and I said to Vahid last semester. From this year, they are pulling the school projects out of the analytic school program in Greece right now. So in the last 5 years, the main idea is that to start mixing the courses and have the school projects, and they were becoming like a main thing in Greece. especially in adult education, but now it was also passing in the elementary schools. So the students had time during the analytic program to do things in the school projects. But now the new decision of the ministry is that they want students to focus in the core courses, so do 2 hours more mathematics per week instead of doing school projects. And they demand from the willing teachers to work after hours for that. And this is going to be a big drawback for us, because we were really getting advantage of this time, because they had to cover this and they wanted ideas of how to cover in a creative way. And if this goes after hours and becomes optional, probably many teachers would cancel an idea of making school projects, because this also demands from them voluntary time to do it. And the other thing that we have to do is, of course, now get advantage of all these connections we did. And because I get emails every day, really every day, to go to schools and to do something like that there. And this is in our plans for this year. This is the things. Yeah, so questions I have. This is my part. I'm on time, yeah?
2 questions. One is, if you are using WordPress as a shell on top of the knowledge base that you are using from Wikipedia, and whether you are having not only the content management but also the educational management, like scheduling or evaluation, etc. Do you do that?
We do evaluation with 2 ways. We check the statistics in this way, and by questionnaires and quizzes that we ask them to do. And we also use this extension tool in the Wikipedia to monitor if they still are active after all this thing, because we want to see if these editors are active 6 months later or 1 year later. And of course we have the same problems like everybody else. Most of the teachers become inactive after some time. And on the other side, we use WordPress because our main the user group page it's written in WordPress, and we just created a sub page on that, and we were very lucky to find this LearnPress plugin that really works very very good. It has very very good statistics inside. You can even measure your own progress and make a threshold in order to go to the next lesson module. You have to finish the week's assignments, etc., etc. And of course, we do a lot of things manually, yeah, in order to allow them to go later. I really have to check by myself if they have written something in Wikipedia. For example, we asked them to make 10 edits in English Wikipedia. I had to do this manually and reply to everyone in their own wiki page manually. For example, one assignment was something very easy. Like, send me a greeting in English Wikipedia in my talk page. And I had to reply to each one manually, 150 times.
And my second question is about whether you have looked through standard content development methods, like using SCORM or other formats.
No, never. No, I also heard some very good ideas about MOOCs here, but I didn't know anything about it before, to be honest. I think we worked a lot independently. We didn't really knew about the things happening in the area, which is weird, because I participate in all these education meetings, and this is the first time I hear about a MOOC, for example. Yeah.
I have no questions, but as for me, I think that involved teachers, it's very important and good for them, for teachers, to enrich their linguistic, their grammatical materials and their intellect, to inform by every aspect. Maybe it's good.
Yeah, that
involved teachers.
All the questioners say that they really find it valuable and they would like to continue working. So it probably it fails somewhere else, because most of the people are really willing to continue. As they really write letters that they love the experience and they would like to contribute more in Wikipedia. But something is failing during the progress in order to keep all these people and become them to as active Wikipedians or Wikimedians. I still haven't found the answer for that. I mean, it's a good question, because even for photos, because we worked a lot with Commons, and this became very, very interesting, because we saw some people participating in this, and then they started becoming active in the photo contests we were creating. In fact, we had a good thing. For example, in Corfu, in my island, I was asked, and we created Corfupedia last year. It was a project to write about the Greek local history, and there were like 30 teachers participating and more than 100 students from the island participating, and this was a result of that. Maybe not exactly, but because of the, I don't know, not completely connected. Yeah, you did something in Finland probably, yeah, already.
sorry. Time is running, yes, so okay. We have one more speaker. So
yes,
if you have questions for some discussion during coffee break,
just a question. And a question.
There is a lot of questions, but we have 10 minutes till 3, and we have one more speaker. So, sorry.
Okay, find me during coffee time.
During coffee time, right? And we have thank you, Mario, a lot.
Those questions.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
So my email, everything is Magiladitis. There's no surprises. Username Magiladitis, Magiladitis email, Twitter Magiladitis. It's so easy. Just find me.
Yeah, we will.